This meeting is now being recorded. Okay, 43 orang daripada 63. Kalau yang ada masalah lain, if you know the problem awal-awal, then you can let me know lah. Okay. Hari ini kita tidak dipantau, jadi kita boleh buat macam biasa. But if anyone still wants to open their camera, so I have someone to look at, that is also very welcome. Hari ini bukan di office lah, hari ini di BT kosong. So, I am not as shy as last week. Okay. Right. Jam sudah menunjukkan 8.33 pagi. Jadi saya akan start dengan kelas kita lah. How is everyone? Busy. What are you busy with this week? Or last week? Okay, Akil is alive. I'm glad. Alicia very good. Eveliska is good. Mungkin ada yang baru bangun. Thank you juga lah yang baru bangun tuh. Okay. At least you're alive, even if you're busy and you're crying inside. That's okay. Let us continue with life and hopefully not die. Okay. So, like I said just now, today we are going to discuss the experiment 5. So just as a recap, what we did in last week, sepatutnya last week, all of you have filled in the Google Sheet that records your data. Let me just, how do I share screen? Okay, my entire screen. Okay. Right, so now you should be able to see my screen. I am showing people your class. This is K06. Okay, so last week I gave you the materials for experiment 5. So material for experiment 5 termasuklah kamu punya lab manual, video, dua video, satu untuk yang hidung-hidung, satu lagi video untuk darah-darah. And then I gave you the pre-lab module and also the answers. If you have any problem with the pre-lab modules and answers, please let me know. Kalau tidak sempat, what to do? Kalau sempat buat dan sudah siap buat, ada tanda, kamu akan nampak bahwa pre-lab module itu actually membantu pemahaman kamu. Okay, so that is what is the material I gave you, and then I gave you the link for the Google Sheets. Here we shall look at the Google Sheet. Ini untuk K04. Yang kolom untuk phenotype, yang 6 phenotype itu tidak masalah lah kan? Because you can look at your own nose, you can look at your own earlobe, your tongue, your dimple, your hands, and your thumb. Cuma yang blood group itu saya minta, siapa yang tidak tahu apa blood group, dia jangan isi kosong, kasih blank saja. Itu kolom kamu. So kalau macam ini Akil punya nama kan? No, Afiq. Ini Afiq, dia tahu dia blood group B, so blood group B dia tulis 1, everything else is 0. And I have also put the formula down here. Siapa yang belum pernah Google Sheet, saya cerita. Okay, so in Google Sheet or in Excel, you can put in formula. So tidak payah kamu yang kira, kamu biar software itu sahaja yang kira. So what I put in here is I put the formula to count how many people have this phenotype. Itulah formula dia, sum from this cell to this cell. And then, of course, the Google Sheet will calculate the total number of people who have that phenotype for each column. And then here, I put in the formula so that it will calculate the frequency. Jadi, menurut formula yang saya tulis di sini, ini untuk membantu siapa yang tidak biasa dengan sheets, ya. The formula basically says it will take the value from here and divide it by 22. Ini tempat kamu tengok formula. So for this one, the six phenotypes for class K04, it will be divided by 22. Untuk yang blood group itu, sebab ada beberapa orang yang tidak tahu dia punya blood group apa, kenapa ada kosong? Ada beberapa orang yang tidak tahu dia blood group apa. So I have taken the number of students in your class minus the number of people who don't know their blood group, and then I change the formula lah. Oh, why is it divided by? Siapa yang mengisi ini? Uzair. Uzair tahu kan blood group apa? If you know what is your blood group, terus isi sekarang. If not, then leave it blank. Jangan tulis kosong. Okay, so this one is already adjusted to the number of people who know their blood group. Alright. And then I gave you some lab report guideline. Saya bagi satu slot untuk kamu hantar kamu punya lab report dan saya ada bagi guideline ini. So guideline ini cakap apa yang kamu perlu ada dalam lab report kamu dan saya bagi lagi untuk conclusion, saya bagi tahu apa yang perlu ditulis dalam bentuk ayat. Reference macam mana mau tulis pun saya bagi dalam bentuk ayat dan part yang tidak perlu tulis pun saya bagi tahu di sini. Okay, so far any problems? Oh, and also on YouTube, I gave you extra instructions video. So, ada yang ada tengok last week, then you would see me with my messy hair telling you how to fill in the Google Sheet. Setakat ni ada sebarang masalah. Any problem with that? Before I use one person's example to discuss what to have in the lab report. Eviliska, tiada masalah. Everybody else, no problem, no question? Shiloh, tiada masalah.
Miss?
Yes?
If my report already checked by you, right, is that the final final result? Or I can just pass out the new one?
I already marked. Yeah, I already marked the one you submitted.
There's something wrong in the report, right?
In the what?
In my report. Something wrong in my report.
Okay, later you point out what is wrong. So right now I'm looking, okay, everybody else doesn't have question. If everybody else don't have question, we'll look at your lab report. Actually, saya mau tengok setiap kelas ada berapa orang sudah hantar. Dan memang saya bagi deadline yang panjang sedikit lah. I purposely gave you a longer deadline because just in case you are busy with other stuff, I want you to focus on the stuff with marks first. So this one is due October 11th. K04, one person has turned in. Rahma sudah hand in, very good. For K05, one person has turned in, which is Lim, ini yang saya sudah tanda. And for K06, nobody has turned in yet, so I hope at least one of you hands in soon. Okay, mari kita tengok lab report Lim. Which part did you change, Lim? Your newer version?
No, Miss. I mean, like you already checked, right? But I need to do correction or pass out?
Can do correction, but only for the part that you're wrong lah. No need to redo. Eh, wait, you're doing this digitally. Oh, redo the whole thing lah. Main edit sudah kan.
Okay.
Kalau tulis tangan, then you only write the part that you
wrong. Okay. Okay, thank you, Miss.
Right, everybody else can see this? Everybody else can see your friend's work? Jangan jealous, dia ada computer, boleh type. Okay, so this is Lim's lab report. All right, so what he has here is he has a cover page So sini Lim ada buat cover page, ada College Matricula Silabuan, ada logo, dia pandai dia cari biology, lab report, experiment 5, inheritance, ada nama, ada matrix number, ada class. Kalau boleh, this one is not very particular lah, but for me, I like it when you can align the titik-titik. Like this thing, if possible, I want it all to line up here. Supaya nama sini, number matrix sini, plus sini, nama saya sini. Sini biar ada ruang kosong sikit. But that is not a great problem and you are not being graded on this. Ini cover page dia ada markah pun. Cover page ini cuma untuk kasih cantik sikit supaya saya tidak sakit kepala tengok. And try to figure out which experiment this is. So far, this cover page, no big problem. And this is how he has done his lab report. So memang start dengan title. So here is the title. Wait, ada yang sudah tanda. Kalau saya macam tidak jelas ataupun terlampau laju, nanti kamu beritahu saja ya. Okay, so here he has the title and the objective. So sini dia punya title, ini objektif dia, salin balik sahaja macam dalam lab manual. And the introduction. Introduction kamu boleh salin daripada lab manual ataupun kamu boleh ringkaskan. If you are typing, of course you don't mind copy pasting kan. Kalau kamu menulis dan then kamu akan rajin sedikit untuk kasih ringkas. Paraphrasing means rearranging the sentence so that it still has the same meaning, but the delivery is a little different. Okay, so paraphrasing, kasih susun balik ayat sekejap, basically. Apparatus and materials, Google Sheets, itu sahaja. And for the observation, he put in table 5.1. Okay, so kalau boleh, this is the thing about putting tables in digital format, ya. Kalau boleh, saya suka kamu masukkan table itu, seluruh table itu dalam muka surat yang sama. Kadang-kadang memang tidak muat dan tidak dapat masukkan, then that's okay. But where possible, try to fit in the whole table in one page. And make sure when you have table, you draw the line. Okay, kemas macam mana pun jadual kamu, mesti lukis garis, terutamanya kalau kamu tulis guna tangan. So, mesti ada dia punya garis melintang, garis lurus dan mesti ada label. You must label your tables and diagrams that you put into your work. So, this one should be table 5.1. Lepas tu kalau kamu rajin, kamu tulislah apa yang ada dalam table ini. You explain that table 5.1 is observed and expected frequencies of each genotype for 6 characteristics in the class. So here you put in shape of nose, straight nose, curved nose, earlobe, pre-earlobe, attached earlobe. Now I want to ask one person. Who should I ask? Mary Holly? Can you see my screen, Mary?
Yes, miss.
Okay, Mary, saya mau tanya. Untuk genotype ini, macam straight nose ini kan, dia E besar. Lepas tu ada garis. Curve nose pula I kecil, I kecil. Kenapa yang ini dia punya genotype lain daripada kita belajar dalam buku? Kenapa dia I besar lepas tu ada garis? Can you answer the question?
No,
okay. Anybody else knows why it is like that? Nobody?
Abis dia belum ditentukan lagi test cross dia. Belum kena kasih
okay.
Test. Jadi dia sama ada dia I besar atau I besar, I kecil.
Okay, very good, Pharaoh. That is correct. So, this one, sebab kita tidak tahu orang yang straight nose dalam kelas kamu itu adalah homozygous dominant ataupun heterozygous. Dan kalau mau buat test cross untuk setiap kamu, malaslah mau tunggu sampai anak kamu besar. Jadi kita tulis saja genotype bagi orang yang straight nose E blank. Blank supaya dia merangkumi yang E besar E besar dan E besar E kecil. So that it includes both homozygous dominant and heterozygous individuals. So thank you for your answer, Vero. Good try, Mary. Okay, next time saya tanya kamu soalan lagi ya, Mary. Alright. So what else do I need to ask you? Okay. So you copy this table from your lab manual and then you tick your own genotype. And then you will write down the observed frequency of each genotype in the class and the expected frequency of each genotype. Make sure that you are using the same number of decimal places for that column. Okay, walaupun kamu bahagi-bahagi-bahagi, kamu boleh dapat number yang cantik macam 0.8, 0.2 dan 1.0. Kamu tengok dalam satu kolom tu, the baris tu, kalau ada satu value pun yang jadi 2 decimal place, value yang lain pun kamu tambahlah 0 untuk jadikan dia 2 decimal place juga. So like this, you have 0.65. So this one you should have 0.80, ini pun 9010 sepatutnya. Memang kalau kita masukkan data dalam table, dia mesti ikut decimal place atau significant place yang sama. Same thing applies to your expected frequency. Okay, somebody else I would like to ask. Shalini, are you there?
Yes, miss.
Okay, Shalini, can you tell me what is observed frequency and what is expected frequency? Kenapa kita ada dua kolom yang berbeza di sini?
Sebab observe tu boleh dinampak kan, miss? Maksud expected tu yang kita kira tu kan, miss?
Okay, ya. Kita kira berdasarkan apa yang expected frequency?
Berdasarkan table kah?
Not quite. But good try. Thank you. Does anybody other than Shalini know where you get the expected frequency? Kenapa saya bagi tahu kamu 0.75 atau 0.25 sahaja? Anybody? Tiada? Yap pun tidak tahu?
Tak, miss.
Okay. Then I will explain to you. Kalau tidak, 30 minit kita di sini. Alright. This expected frequency kita dapat daripada genetic diagram. Kamu ingat kalau chapter 4, genetic inheritance yang kita buat heterozygous, cross dengan heterozygous, kita akan dapat phenotypic frequency of offspring 3:1 ratio. Okay, chapter 4, genetic inheritance, kalau kita ambil E besar E kecil cross dengan E besar E kecil, anak-anak dia akan ada phenotypic frequency 3 straight nose, 1 curve nose. So it is following this concept. Kita andaikan dalam populasi kelas kamu, kamu semua berasal daripada parents yang heterozygous. Then what is the expected frequency? yang kita jangka. So that 3 nisbah 1, 3 dia 3 bahagi dengan 4 jadilah 0.75. So this is from 3 to 1 ratio. This will be 3 over 4. This one is 1 over 4. So itulah kenapa yang dominant phenotype dalam table ini, dia punya expected frequency semua 0.75. Dia punya recessive phenotype, expected frequency dia semua 0.25. That part is clear? Anybody have any more question?
Clear, miss.
All right. Then I would like to ask another question. Kenapa kita punya observed frequency untuk setiap genotype ini tidak sama dengan expected frequency? Ada yang hampir-hampir lah, macam yang 0.8 dengan 0.2 ni, hampir-hampir apa yang kita expect. Tapi ada yang langsung tidak sama. Contoh yang macam dimple, 0.45 banding dengan 0.55. Why is that? Why is there a difference? Cincai sudah jawab, tidak payah ayat yang cantik sama.
Dia tidak follow Mendelian inheritance-nya loh.
Good try, but not quite. This one is something that does follow Mendelian's inheritance.
Oh, okay.
Kalau dia does follow, kenapa dia punya ratio lain sedikit daripada apa yang kita sangka? Anybody have a clue? Okay, mungkin ada yang terfikir tapi dia tidak pasti kan betul atau tidak jawaban dia. So I'll just let you know. When we follow the Mendel punya, that is we are assuming that everybody in the beginning starts with heterozygous. Ataupun same number of this allele, same number of recessive allele. Tapi actually bila kita tengok population kita sekarang, bukan semua parents kita adalah heterozygous straight nose. Dan mungkin di kampung kamu kah, di kampung orang lain, memang lebih banyak parents yang dia punya hidung adalah straight nose berbanding dengan curved nose. Ataupun di kampung Vero, mungkin lebih ramai orang di kampung dia more curved nose than straight nose. You have different observed frequency of each genotype because you have different allele frequency in your population. Kalau memang kebetulan population kamu ramai orang yang curved nose, memanglah kamu tidak akan ikut itu expected frequency. Kalau population kamu ramai orang yang tiada lesung pipit, tiada dimple, then of course your observed ratio, observed phenotypic ratio is going to be different from your expected phenotypic ratio. So short answer is depends on allele frequency in your population. Ada soalan? Adakah jelas saya punya penerangan? Ada sebarang soalan sebelum saya teruskan?
No, miss.
Okay. Let me just check for messages. Jelas. Okay, very good. Alright. So, any more questions about the table? Nanti kamu cari saja observe frequency ini daripada bahagian sini. So, this one for K04. Okay, yang satu ini kamu kasih jadilah 1.00. Ini kamu kasih jadilah 0.00. Ini 0.73, pandai-pandai kamu bundarkan. Okay. Let's see. I don't see any problem with your data. Kali itu K05 paling laju untuk isi. So that is good job for them. Okay, not many problems here. Kalau kita dapat masuk lab, you would be able to do the second part of the experiment 5.2 where you test your own blood group. And we will see when you come back to college if it is possible to do the 5.2 part of the experiment. Mana tahu ada yang mau jadi MA kah, berminat untuk masuk lab, untuk buat kerja yang berkaitan dengan darah. This is a fun experiment to do. Tapi kalau yang takut darah itu tolong duduk sedia supaya saya tidak payah sambut bila kamu pingsan. Okay, so if no problems with 5.1, I'm going to continue with 5.2. 5.2 is very simple. You just put down the possible genotype. Ini yang banyak kali sudah kita isi semasa kita buat chapter 4 punya latihan. And then you put in the observed frequency of each blood group. So this is what you can get from the Google Sheet I give you. Yeah, ini table 5.2 ya. Ataupun 5.3 pun boleh berdasarkan lab manual. Any problems with observation?
Tiada, Miss.
Okay, very good. Then I'm going to continue with the conclusion. Conclusion saya ada bagi fill in the blank. Jadi nanti kamu isi saja. Kamu tidak payah letak penanda wacana pun tidak apa. You don't need to have the sentence connectors pun tidak apa. You just need to tell me what was being determined. What are the frequencies? If you want to list out the frequencies pun boleh. Kalau kamu rajin, kamu mau cakap frequency of genotype of shape curve nose is begini, suka hati kamu lah kalau mau tulis panjang-panjang. Kalau mau tulis pendek, ikut saja apa yang saya bagi. And last but not least, you write down that the objective of the experiment is achieved. Sebab kita berjaya laksanakan kita punya experiment, which is to calculate your frequency. So, sudah siap calculate? Siaplah, tercapailah kita punya matlamat. Dan kemudian kamu tulislah reference kamu. Okay, so here's the thing about reference. When you go into academia, when you go into bidang akademik macam university, macam metrics, okay, kalau kamu mau tulis buku-buku ilmiah, kamu perlu pandai tulis reference. Reference basically means saya tidak mereka fakta-fakta yang saya tulis, saya ambil dari tempat yang boleh sumber yang boleh percaya, dan ini adalah sumber yang boleh percaya itu. Untuk tulis reference, kita ada beberapa jenis format. Kamu mungkin pernah dengar Harvard style citation ataupun APA format citation. What we are using for bio and also for MUET, I think, is APA format citation. Dan dia ada beberapa edisi, ini adalah edisi ke-6. Alright, so in the lab report guideline, I gave you something to copy. But if you want to learn how to write APA citation format, you can ask me for more information or search online. Okay, ini adalah format untuk tulis reference untuk buku. Dan ini adalah dua buku rujukan yang kita biasa gunakan untuk biology peringkat matrix. Pertama adalah buku Campbell. Sebab penulis dia yang pertama adalah Campbell, Neil Campbell. Jadi bila orang mau guna buku teks dia, memang dia gunakan nama orang pertama ni. And the second book that we usually use is another textbook. It is written by Solomon. Solomon and Friends. So kalau kamu mau beli buku, yang paling paling bagus adalah dua buku ini untuk bio. Tapi kalau jarang buka buku, jarang membaca, tidak payah beli, lazim duit. Okay. Any problems with conclusion and references? Okay. I move on.
Okay, Miss.
Okay, thank you. Alright, then we continue to the questions. Question kita letak di hujung. Alright, so the first question is for 5.1. Individuals with certain heterozygous characteristics are usually called a carrier. What does a carrier mean? So in his lab report, Lim gave a good explanation, but unfortunately, the explanation is not for normal carrier, it is for sex-linked inheritance punya carrier. Can somebody tell me what does carrier mean? C-A-R-R-I-E-R. Anybody? Suhada, Najiha, can you hear me?
Yes, miss.
Okay. So can you try answering what is a carrier?
Individual yang carry autosomal recessive disorder.
Okay. All right, hampir. It, you are thinking in terms of disorder. You are thinking in terms of penyakit. Tapi kita boleh juga gunakan carrier untuk ciri-ciri yang bukan penyakit. So you have, you and Lim both have the idea, just that the question is asking carrier in general. So paling senang, kalau kamu mau jawab soalan ni, a carrier is an individual with heterozygous genotype, but shows the dominant phenotype. Phenotype dia adalah yang dominant, genotype dia adalah heterozygous. Ada I besar, ada I kecil. So they are able to pass the recessive allele to their offspring, but they do not show the recessive phenotype themselves. Memang jawapan Lim di sini dan jawapan Syuhada tadi adalah betul. Cuma ikut kehendak soalan. Okay. Anybody have any problem with that? Can I move on to the next question?
Tada, miss.
Alright, thank you, Parahin. Okay, so second question. A student inherited left-handedness from parents who are both right-handed. Explain the pattern of inheritance. Okay, di sini Lim punya jawapan, dia cakap dengan, dia mulakan jawapan dia dengan menjelaskan right-handed is dominant, left-handed is recessive. The student inherited left-handedness from parents who are both right-handed. When both his or her parents are heterozygous, which are one dominant allele and one recessive allele for characteristics of left-handed. Okay, pelajar ini dapat ciri-ciri ini daripada parents dia. Parents dia, kedua-dua parents adalah heterozygous. So the probability of 0.25 that their child born is left-handed in this family. The main point is in the second sentence. So this is a good answer. I think this is not difficult. Mungkin kamu stuck masa kamu mau bina ayat saja. Sebab lama tidak jawab English kan. Jadi ter-nervous, maybe that is what make you stuck. But if you are not stuck, very good. Question number three. Question number three, what is the expected frequency for a person having tongue rolling ability and attached earlobe? So this is a good try. This is good step. Okay, you start by writing the expected frequency of a person with tongue rolling and expected frequency of a person with attached earlobe. Soalan tanya, apakah expected frequency untuk jumpa orang yang boleh gulungkan lidah dan dia punya cuping telinga adalah yang attached? When you are looking at more than one trait, okay, when you're looking at two traits at the same time, you have two choices. One is you make a genetic diagram. Mula genetic diagram, lukis macam kamu buat dihybrid inheritance. Tapi itu panjang dan menyampah. So instead, what you can do is you can multiply the frequency. Kita guna tambah because it doesn't work like that in terms of mathematics. You need to multiply. So you just take this 0.75 times by 0.25. Jawapan kamu tekan, you will get 0.1875. You can simplify this, you can round off to 0.19. Kamu boleh bundarkan dia kalau kamu mau. but you must show the step that you multiply. Any problem with question number 3? Oh, sorry. Tadi dalam chat ramai pula yang menjawab pembawa when we say carrier. Ya, yeah, betul itu pembawa. Okay, question number 3, no problem?
Yes, miss.
Okay, then I'm going to continue with question number 4. Question number 4, what is expected frequency for a person to have all 6 recessive characteristics? Which means dia punya nose curve, dia left-handed, cuping telinga dia, begitulah. You're not gonna times by 6. Instead, you are going to use power of 6. Pilihan kamu adalah kamu boleh cuba kira dengan 0.25 kali 0.25 kali 0.25 kali 0.25 kali 0.25 kali 0.25 for 6 characteristics, so 6 times. Or you can put as 0.25 bracket to the power of 6. Tekan calculator, you're going to get this. Then you can round off into 0.0002. This part, any problem? Any question for number 4? Atau okay, sudah?
Okay, miss.
Okay, miss.
Alright, wonderful. Thank you. Then we are going to the last 2 questions. Okay, the next 2 questions. Can an individual with O blood group donate his blood to an A blood group? Give reason to your answer. Orang yang darah O boleh derma bagi orang darah A? Jawapannya adalah ya. So this is something I think you learn in school before as well. But if you didn't understand in school and you don't understand now, feel free to ask. You can always learn again. Okay, so kenapa orang yang darah O boleh derma bagi orang yang darah A? Sebab darah O tiada sebarang antigen pada permukaan sel darah merah dia. Jadi darah O dia masuk darah siapa-siapa pun, darah O itu tidak akan diserang oleh badan penerima. Ayat yang Lim bagi di sini cukup bagus untuk menjelaskan apa yang berlaku dalam badan penerima. Individual with O blood group can donate. O blood group has no surface antigen. So if blood is introduced to a person with A blood group, antibodies in the person with A blood group, which is anti-B antibodies, will not cause the type of blood to agglutinate. Di sini dia gunakan perkataan clump together, tapi saya mau kamu gunakan perkataan scientific. So the proper word that you should use to describe red blood cells clumping together is agglutinate. A-G-G-L-U-T-I-N-A-T-E. Okay, so, and then he lastly ends it with, does people from type O blood group also known as universal donor? Any problems with question number 1? Okay. Berkenaan darah.
Miss, I just want to ask. I just want to ask that after the sentences are agglutinate, right? I write this situation not only happened in A blood group. Then what is the word? What is the word after A blood group?
Oh, receivers. Penerima, receivers.
I can't understand that word. I thought it's what.
Oh, okay. Sorry, it's not clear here. Okay. Any of you use Kami before? It's a very good app. The only problem is you need internet for it. Okay. All right. So if no problem with question number 1, I'll continue with question number 2. A mother with O blood group gave birth to a baby girl having the same blood group. So baby dia pun blood group O. However, she is not convinced that the baby belongs to her because her husband has AB blood group. She claimed there might be swapping of babies in the nursery. Explain. So you have to explain why the O blood group baby does not belong to this mother and father. Jawapan dia tidak, bukan milik dia. And then you have to explain. You can explain in terms of probability. Macam ini, Lim explain there is 50% probability of them to have baby with B blood group, 0% for them to have baby with O blood group. Ataupun kamu boleh lukis genetic diagram. If you want, and you're writing by hand, you can draw the genetic diagram also. Ataupun kamu boleh nyatakan apa gamet yang ada lah. Okay, you, maybe you want to say that the mother can only produce O gamet, IO. The father can only produce IA, IB. Up to you. I will mark when you hand in your work. Okay, so ini soalan di luar kotak dan mungkin kamu pun terhibur memikir. Kalau betul lah berlaku situasi macam ni, why do you think it happens? Who did something wrong? Why is the baby not A or B blood group? Anybody? Kita cadangan. Betulkah itu baby tertukar? Well, is that really the father?
Miss, there are only two situations. Whether the nurse switched the baby or maybe another probability that not the anak kandung.
yeah, pretty much correct. Mungkin bukan anak dia, mungkin tertukar, or maybe there was a problem with the blood test. Maybe bahan yang digunakan untuk tes darah itu sudah expire. Janganlah kamu terus jump into conclusion. Okay, so yeah. That is fun. Usually when I do the inheritance exercises, the students are very excited because they think of all the drama. Kalau sekarang saya tidak dengar lah kan kamu punya gelak-gelak, tapi kalau di kelas nih, jaga kamu. Okay. So yeah, that is pretty much it. Saya tengok sekejap dulu Rahma punya report. So far, any questions regarding the lab report? Kalau tulis tangan, tiada masalah ya. Jangan segan-segan untuk hantar kerja yang bertulis tangan. Okay, this one is also typed. Okay, when you are handing in your lab report nanti, thank you for handing in, Rahma. I just want to clarify, I don't want to use title macam ni. Title tu boleh kasih cantik lagi. Kalau boleh, saya tidak mau bullet point macam ni. Oh, my pen is not working. Okay. I prefer you don't use like this. For this table. Okay, so this table you didn't label. So, bila-bila kamu bagi table, tolonglah tulis dia adalah table berapa. So, for this one, you should have written table 5.1. Ini sepatutnya table 5.2 ataupun 5.3. And when you are typing, I want you to make sure that you are writing down the alleles properly. So ini dia memang sepatutnya I. Dia sepatutnya sepatutnya superscript IA. Macam tu. Okay, so get to know your software. Biasakan diri menggunakan apa-apa apps ataupun apa-apa gadget yang kamu sedang guna. Pastikan kerja kamu kemas, decimal point tidak hilang. Jangan terus edit dari guideline saya lah, tolong type semula from scratch. Okay. Okay, and then ini questions belum buat. So nanti Rahma tolong buat balik ah kerja ni. Alright. Any questions regarding experiment 5?
Miss, I want to ask again about the career, right? You say that I wrote the explanation about the inheritance set seeding.
Mm-hmm.
Then how I need to write in general, because I reread my sentences, right? But almost same meaning with explanation you met just now.
Yes, but then your explanation, you mentioned the female and male.
Oh,
so when you mentioned female and male, you are hinting that it is on the sex chromosome.
So I need to explain in generally, not to...
Yes, depending on the question. Plus, this experiment is referring to Mendelian inheritance. So kalau dia Mendelian inheritance, dia memang bukan sex-linked. Dia memang pada autosom.
Oh, okay. Thank you, Miss.
Okay, good. Good question. Okay. Right. If there are no more questions about experiment 5, let us have a 3-minute break. Rehat 3 minit dan saya akan masuk balik kepada experiment 3. Is that okay?
Okay, Miss.
All right. Thank you. Miss. So let's have a quick break. We will come back at 9:22.
Okay, Miss.
Bagi yang masih mendengar dan masih di depan laptop atau handphone, banyakkah kerja kamu minggu ini? Do you have a lot to do this week?
Bolehlah, Miss.
Tidak pasti pula. Ada yang cakap boleh, ada yang cakap tidak pasti. Apa kerja yang kamu tahu mesti hantar minggu ini? Ada UPS kah? Subjek lain.
Ada.
Subjek apa?
Science Com.
Oh, okay. Biasa hari berapa lah tuh kamu punya UPS Science Com?
Esok.
Ataupun ini first one?
Besok.
Oh, esok. Okay. Kalau next, biasa hari berapa?
Jumaat.
Jumaat, okay. Esok. Kalau kamu ada masalah kan, terutamanya untuk yang macam UPS punya, kita mau coba selaraskan satu subjek tu dengan beratus pelajar dia. If you have any problem dengan line ke apa-apa, beritahu lecturer kamu awal-awal ya. Nanti lecturer tu ingatkan kamu ni kurang ajar, tidak pandai kontak. Padahal masalah kamu adalah tiada elektrik ataupun gadget kamu ada masalah. So kalau kita inform awal, boleh mengelakkan salah faham. Tidaklah lecturer kamu tiba-tiba macam tidak. Message dia dapat dijawab. Okay. Okay, bagi yang beredar daripada laptop tadi, sila datang balik. Alright, so it seems that you're not that busy this week, so I hope there is no excuse. This week, I would like you to do the experiment 3. Week 9 sudah kan? So kita akan buat itu experiment 3 yang potato tu, transport across membrane. Ada yang bahannya belum sampai, yang sudah order dari Shopee 3 minggu lebih tapi bahannya belum sampai-sampai? Okay, I don't hear anybody saying that their syringe is not here. Beaker, dia mau fancy sikit kan, jadi dia order beaker tapi beaker dia belum sampai. No such problem, ya. So if you don't tell me today, then I'm going to assume that you are able to do your experiment. You are just lazy and didn't do. Mesti buat eksperimen minggu ini, kecuali kalau ada kes yang betul-betul tidak boleh, sila bagi tahu saya secara personal. Alright, let us recap on experiment 3. So, untuk memudahkan kerja kamu, tadi saya sudah buat topik baru dalam GC. So, sekarang kalau kamu masuk GC, you can go straight to practical test material. Here you will find the material for experiment 3. Okay, ini ada Google folder dia. So if you're going in the folder, you should be able to find the lab manual. Instruction for your practical test. And a template for your lab report. Izinkan saya cakap dulu pasal lab manual. So this is the lab manual, you can read it. I also put the link here in the GC, kalau kamu mau terus dari GC. Ini adalah list apparatus dengan materials yang kamu perlu sediakan. Kalau kamu tidak dapat sediakan penimbang digital, misalnya, kita ada alatan alternatif. Dan step untuk peralatan alternatif itu akan ditulis dalam kotak. So, 3.1, you need to prepare the stock solution, which is the sugar solution. Okay, ikutlah instruction di sini yang sama dengan video. Kalau kamu tidak dapat jumpa penimbang, kamu boleh gunakan sudu teh. Sudu teh means the small sudu, not whatever sudu you use for your drinks. Has to be the small one, but if you have something that measures 1 TSP, itu pun sudu teh. So that is even better. And then you can add water. Make sure you have something to measure your water. Jangan main agak saja guna mata. Carilah peralatan yang kamu boleh guna untuk sukat volume air kamu. And make sure you stir it properly, and that will be the stock solution that you use for 3.2. 3.2, you need to dilute your solution. So you need 3 more glass or container. You are going to label it as A, B, C and prepare it according to these measurements. So dia akan ada konsentrasi kepekatan yang berbeza. Yang pertama, ini dia punya kepekatan 0.1 molar. Yang kedua, 0.5 molar. Yang ketiga, 0.9 molar. Di sini kami swap sudah bagi tahu kamu berapa kepekatan dia dan berapa bilangan air, berapa bilangan, berapa sukatan untuk sugar solution. Tapi kalau kamu tidak bagi, kamu masih boleh kira volume of sugar solution needed and volume of water needed using this formula. So ini adalah formula yang kamu nampak masa chemistry juga. M1V1 equals to M2V2. Initial molarity and initial volume of sugar solution. And also final molarity, final volume of solution. Ini kalau kamu mau cuba belajar, boleh cuba kira dulu sendiri. Kalau kurang pasti, kurang jelas, boleh PM tepi atau tanya di grup. Macam mana guna ini formula. Okay, so 3.1, 3.2, you are preparing the sugar solution. After that is 3.3, preparing potato strip. So ini adalah arahan macam mana mau sediakan potato tu. If you cannot get syringe, then you can use knife. Kamu boleh potong guna pisau. pastikan dia punya size dan panjang sama. Ataupun kamu boleh juga gunakan straw. Straw plastik itu tidak dapatlah, dia terlampau lembik. Tapi kamu boleh gunakan straw besi itu. Kan sekarang kan masih trend untuk guna reusable metal straw. You can use the metal straw. Just make sure you have some way to push the potato out after you use the metal straw. Yang penting, selepas 3.3, kamu boleh dapatkan potato yang sama size. Dan jangan pendek daripada 4 cm. Potato kamu mestilah lebih dari 4 cm, sebab kalau dia terlampau pendek, kamu tidak akan nampak perbezaan panjang dia nanti. Lepas tu kamu stres, kamu menangis, kamu makan tu potato pun kamu makan tidak lalu. So make sure you get a slightly longer potato. Kalau mau sampai 6 cm pun boleh if you have a big enough potato. Okay, and don't forget to measure the length before. Lepas tu kamu rendam dalam solution dia 40 minit. Kasih keluar, kasih kering, terus sukat dia punya panjang. Initial average length means that 3 batang potato tu sebelum kamu kasih masuk, kamu sukat, kamu kira, divide by 3, itulah average dia. Lepas rendam, kasih keluar, sukat, that is your final average length. Selepas itu, difference in length is final minus initial. Bukan, tidak semestinya yang tolak besar tolak kecil. Yang panjang akhir tolak panjang asal. To get your difference in length. So akan ada positif, akan ada negatif. Tonicity is kamu tulis dia hypertonic, isotonic atau hypotonic sahaja. Okay, ada video demo, nanti boleh tengok di YouTube kalau kurang faham. Dan jawab soalan-soalan yang ada di sini. Okay, and this is picture instructions. What else do I need to tell you? And then when you do your experiment, when you do your experiment, you need to record a video of yourself. For the other experiments, you don't need to record. Kalau kamu mau record untuk saja-saja post di Instagram, post di TikTok, yeah, sure, whatever, up to you. But for this one, you must record something in decent quality. Kamu mau record meluruskan, melintangkan, that is fine. But what is important is your video is not too long. Janganlah 40 minit tu, 40 minit juga lah kamu record dan bagi saya video. Boleh sunting, edit part yang tidak penting. Apa part yang penting? Well, you need to show yourself doing the experiment. So, mesti ada tunjukkan muka kamu, tunjukkan yang kamu jalankan setiap step experiment. Lepas kamu siap edit video kamu, tiada lagu pun tidak apa. Kalau mau lagu, okay juga, no problem. And make sure that the image is clear. You can upload it to YouTube or you can upload it to Google Drive. And then you just give me the link in GC. Your video must be less than 5 minutes. Please submit before 11 October. Untuk minggu ini buat, record, edit dan hantar pada saya selewat-lewatnya minggu depan hari Kamis. Ini tidak berapa cantik pun tidak apa, saya akan komen apa yang kurang, apa yang bagus supaya kamu ada masa untuk perbaiki. Final deadline is 15 Oktober. Kalau kamu tidak pasti apa yang perlu ada dalam kamu punya video, kamu boleh tengok ini, PDF, double check your video. Okay, ini disediakan oleh lecturer lain. So, dia pun campur-campur BM dengan BI dia lah. Okay, so dia cakap sini sekurang-kurangnya ada satu snapshot yang ada muka, tunjukkan material, tunjukkan yang kamu follow, step, reset, balance, so boleh ikut ini satu-satu untuk tengok sama ada kamu ada bahan yang saya mau bagi markah atau tidak. Eh, tengok siapa dalam video tu. Eh, macam kenal. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask. Data daripada kamu punya eksperimen tu, yang kira-kira tu, jangan dulu buang ya. Sebab kamu perlu buat kamu punya lab report. So this is about your lab report. This is the part about lab report. In the Google Drive, you will have this template. So, ini adalah template yang kamu boleh print ataupun kamu boleh tulis tangan. Tolong jangan type. For the lab report, I don't want you guys to type because if you type, there is a chance you can just copy-paste from other places and other people can copy and paste your answers if they find it. So, I want you to write by hand. Kalau kamu ada gadget yang canggih, contohnya kamu cukup duit untuk ada iPad, then you can write on the iPad. But make sure you are using blue or black ink only. Jangan tiba-tiba merah, hijau, purple, rainbow di sini. Okay, so isi saja, salin macam kamu salin title, tulis macam kamu tulis objektif, isi ini table, siap lagi kami bagi garis. And then you need to analyze your results. Ini adalah bahagian discussion. Discussion means you are discussing what was in your result. Kamu bincangkan kenapa result kamu begitu. Adakah kamu berjaya atau gagal? Kalau gagal, apa sebab kamu gagal? For this experiment 3, we give you this template yang macam isi tempat kosong. So you just follow here. Okay, in cup A, what is the change in length? Did it grow longer? Okay, did it increase in length or did it reduce in length? Decrease in length or no changes in length? Lepas tu, berdasarkan tonicity, kamu cakaplah sucrose solution in cup A is hypertonic, isotonic ataupun hypertonic. Concept of osmosis, then you need to explain water potential dalam sel ataupun dalam sucrose solution lebih tinggi. Water diffuse in or diffuse out of the cell. Repeat for every cup. And then you describe the condition of potato cells. Condition of potato cells ini kamu dah cakap dia terjit ataupun dia flaccid. Dia keras ataupun dia lembik. Okay, and then objectives, cuba-cuba tulis, nanti saya akan tanda apa yang kamu hantar. And you also need to answer the questions. If we have time, I think we will discuss this next week. Okay, kalau sempat kita akan discuss next week ataupun minggu selepas tu. And then you need to write references. Sini kami sudah guna contoh Campbell. Kamu perlu cari dua lagi reference lain. Pandai-pandai pergi cari dan cuba ikut format FPA citation yang betul. So you can print this or you can write it by hand. Okay, I think that is what I need to tell you. Nanti video kamu boleh post di sini, post mana-mana bagi link di sini. Of course now nobody has handed in yet, that's fine. Ini saya ada tulis markah 10 points, tapi ini bukan markah PB kamu ya. Ini adalah untuk saya bagi kamu maklum balas supaya kamu tahu video kamu okey atau tidak. Okay, so far any questions about experiment 3?
Miss?
Yes.
For the lab report, right, we need to rewrite it or follow the manual.
Like, rewrite which part?
Like rewrite the whole the lab report become turn into like just like the lab report for experiment 5.
No. If you're copying, you are going to copy according to this template.
Oh, so we just need to fill in the observation.
Fill in the blanks. Yeah.
For the if, video
okay, I'll just add a bit about the lab report. Kalau kamu dapat datang sini face-to-face untuk eksperimen amali, if you're able to come here face-to-face for the test, we will print out this template for you dengan dia punya jadual-jadual kami yang print. Tinggal kamu datang, kamu nervous-nervous buat eksperimen, bergegar. Lepas siap eksperimen dengan tangan bergegar, kamu akan duduk dan kamu akan jawab dengan tangan yang bergegar menggunakan template yang kami print untuk bagi kamu. But since you're at home, you have to copy by hand. That is all. Okay, Lim, your next question.
Miss, I just want to ask one more. Copy by hand, that means that we need to recopy it and fill in the blank ourselves, lah.
Mm-hmm. So we can print. You can print.
We can just use this. We can just use this example.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. And then my next question is, like in the video, when I'm doing the experiment 3 in the video, I must show my face whole time.
Not the whole time, lah. At least some parts in the video, it's you.
How about I only show my face at introduction, then after that, I don't show my face already.
In the introduction, it should be you doing some of the steps, yes.
Because I cannot, like, I cannot, therefore, I cannot record my face when I'm doing experiment. Because
yeah,
I
yeah.
record the table in different, how to say, different view. Like I'm record the thing on the table and the camera cannot record my face.
Okay, yeah, that is fine. Try with this first example first, and then I will watch your videos. I will let you know if there's any parts to improve.
Okay, thank you, Miss.
Okay. Janganlah in the introduction, it's your face of 18 years old, muda-muda. But then when I see the hands doing the experiment, it's your father's hairy hands. Janganlah ketara sangat. That's why we asked to show your face.
Miss, because of this video, we can only record a video less than 5 minutes, right? Can I just edit the video and increase the speed of the video like 4 times faster than the original video?
Can.
Okay. That's more of my question. Thank you, Miss.
Anybody else have any other questions? Kalau yang ada adik di rumah tu, if you want to bully your younger brother and your younger sister, paksalah dia tolong record. Or if you have already bought the TikTok punya camera stand, phone stand, tu gunalah yang itu. Kalau tidak pun kasih sandar di meja ke, pastikan tidak terkena apa-apa yang membahayalah.
Miss.
Yes.
Kira-kira berapa kali Miss mau tengok kami punya muka dalam video?
Sekurang-kurangnya 1 kali, minimum 1.
Oh.
You want to show your face the whole video? No problem.
Okay.
Okay, if any of you are like Evelista, you have a younger sibling to bully, go ahead. Mak kamu marah, beritahu nah untuk kerja sekolah ni. No more question? Sila buat eksperimen tu minggu ni ya. Record. Dan cuba upload. Kalau boleh buat lab report dan upload juga. Nanti saya sediakan slot PGC.
Miss?
Ya?
Macam mana dengan tata cara pemakaian dalam video?
Asalkan jangan seksi.
Okay.
Yang sesuai lah, yang sesuai sopan. Tidak payah sampai baju kurung. T-shirt dengan seluar pun tiada masalah. Tapi janganlah sampai full attire baju iban tu dengan loceng-locengnya sekali. Itu tidak practical untuk lab eksperimen. Bukan aim iban saja, semua. Patriotik sangat hari Malaysia. Don't need to do that for the video. Okay, no problem. Cantik nih video kamu nanti. Kalau kamu mau kasih cantik dengan lagu-lagu, boleh. Dengan dia punya efek-efek pun boleh. But, mau kasih voice over pun boleh. Tapi tidak penting sangat. Untuk semester ni, saya tidak nilai berdasarkan kualiti video kamu. Tapi untuk sem depan, kamu akan mula dinilai melalui kualiti digital. Okay, so starting from next semester, if we are doing any digital assignment, I will also look at whether or not you know how to use PDF, whether the app that you are using to edit the project is suitable or not. Kalau ada lagi kalau ada lagi hasil kerja video pada semester depan, kami akan mula tengok kualiti dia. So, kamu pandai guna lagu yang sesuai kah? Audio kamu okay kah tidak? adakah sebahagian video tu screen dia blank saja lepas ada lagu di belakang. It's like that lah. But your generation has an advantage. You are Gen Z and you are born into a high-tech world and you are very good at handling technology. Banyak benda yang kami tidak perlu ajar kamu pun, kamu sudah pandai buat dan explore sendiri. So that is an advantage for your generation. I hope that you can continue to improve your technical skills, technical digital skills. Okay, betul, tidak soalan lain nih.
Miss, for this time, right? Do we need to record our voice like we are talking about the procedure?
You don't have to.
But how about the second one? Do we necessarily need to talk about the procedure?
Second one means second semester?
Yeah,
second semester, we'll see first if there is any project.
Okay, thank you, Miss.
But if you choose to narrate your video, it might be easier for me to know which step you are doing. Kalau kamu bukan bercakap, kamu ada tulis something di dalam video tu, then itu akan membantu saya tahu, okay, ini adalah 5.1, 3.1, ini adalah 3.2, ini adalah 3.3.
Yeah, Miss, I will write the procedure, but I don't dare to talk.
Okay, yang lain kita soalan? Malu-malu. Okay, tolong gunakan potato saja ya. Selain daripada potato, kalau betul-betul kamu ni PKPD lockdown sampai tidak dapat gali potato di luar pun, barulah komplain dengan saya kamu kena potato. Kalau setakat malas pergi pasar ataupun terlupa pergi beli, itu tidak diterima. Okay, if there are no problems, then I will conclude this discussion for lab reports. Let us take a 1 hour break. Pukul 11 baru kita sambung dengan chapter 6 dan selepas saya explain 6.1, 6.2 selepas sedikit, saya akan beritahu kamu pasal assignment. Sorry lah, today is a lot of giving you information. So this video is already 10 marks. Your lab report yang isi-isi tempat kosong tu pun 15 markah. Dan assignment PB yang berdasarkan chapter 6 saya akan beritahu pukul 11 nanti itu adalah 10 markah. So yeah, heavy stuff today. For the experiment 5, kalau ada yang belum siap, bukan kalau ada yang belum siap lab report, yang belum buat lab report itu, you can wait a few more weeks to hand in. Because this experiment 3 is more important. Okay. Everything clear? Shall we end the class?
Clear, Miss.
All right. Any more questions, feel free to ask in Telegram. Thank you very much, everybody. And I will see you again at 11 o'clock. Link yang sama.
Thank you, Miss.
Thank you.
Thank you, Miss.
Thank you, Miss.